words, what do really successful people do that most people don't? Of course, there were the typical responses of genetic and luck and talent. But there's an added element that most don't think of. It's the ability to handle the boredom of training every day and doing the same lifts and drills over and over again that separates the professionals from the amateurs. Think about it this way. It's not that the best athletes have some insane passion or willpower that others don't have. It's the exact opposite. They can feel the same boredom and lack of motivation that everyone else feels. They aren't immune to the daily grind. What sets them apart is their commitment to the process. They fall in love with that daily practice, with the repetition, and with the plan in front of them. Therefore, if you want to be a starting quarterback, you have to be in love with running drills and studying playbooks. If you want to be a New York Times bestseller, you have to be in love with the process of writing. If you want to get in better shape, you have to love the practice of eating in a healthier manner and exercising consistently. You have to love the grind if you ever hope to turn it into the achievement of a goal. Our session today will address 5 short-term solutions for managing a slump, mitigating boredom, and developing a carefully balanced mix of deliberate grind and patience. Not in a slump? Don't worry. If you implement a few of our suggestions, your great year can continue to evolve into something even greater. Before we jump in, recognize that there's a difference between a slump and being burned out. I know that sometimes there can be some overlapping between the two, but a slump is you're just having a string of bad luck, and it might be a very long string, but we just need to re-engage and get some good things happening and pull yourself out of it. A burnout is, you know, I'm really getting to the point of the end of my excitement level of doing the same thing over and over again. That doesn't mean that the job itself is going to change completely, but as an example, the burnout is, I've been doing this for 5 years. I've been saying the same thing to candidates. I've been saying the same thing to clients. I've been hearing the same stuff, and I'm just a little bit tired of it. That's the difference. A burnout is different than going through a slump. Today, we're going to cover solutions for the slump. Because a burnout is solved by adding responsibilities to your plate, by building a team around you, and by outsourcing the competencies that are the lower level competencies that would allow you to spend more time in the high level surgery. Now, in order to do that, you have to have a business that someone wants to be a part of. So if you're in a burnout, you've got to almost treat it like a slump so that you can create the momentum needed of billings and then developing enough quality of quantity business that you can support the hours and the payroll of a team around you. So even if you're feeling burned out, address it like a slump so you can pull yourself out of it long enough that you give yourself options for a long-term solution. Okay, so let's get started. Number one is commit to change. Commit to change. What can this look like? It could be, I'm going to change up my script. I know I'm in a slump, let me change my voicemail script. Maybe let me change how I'm introducing myself and my services. Let me change how I overcome the we have no needs objection. It could be, I'm going to try something new and put an email client development campaign in place. Maybe I'm going to reach out to a different set of clients in a tangential area because my current market is not what it used to be. It could be as small as I'm going to listen to upbeat music on my way to work and not talk radio. Maybe instead of taking the car to work for the next month, I'm going to ride my bike. Maybe I'm going to get a new haircut. Maybe I'm going to commit to changing and sending 10 emails personally to prospective clients a day. Maybe I'm going to change and do a case study on the most notable placement that we've made in the last 6 months. Maybe I'm going to change by having our whole team do a group workout twice a week. We're all going to go on a bike ride at lunch. Maybe it's I'm actually going to do a lunch and learn webinar once a month for the next quarter for any hiring managers that are in my space. You say, what would be the subject of those lunch and learn webinars? It can be anything. It can be on how do you create a successful interviewing process? How do you pre-close a candidate and get them excited to accept everything about your organization except for the offer so that they're fired up about the other 95 things and not the one thing that's the compensation? It could be that you're going to do a webinar on a series of changes and shifts that you see in your market. Maybe it's a list of screening questions that you'd ask during the interview. So within this first tip, I've given you more than a dozen sub-tips, but each require you to be conscious of actually committing to doing something different.